Welcome back or welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Josh, I'm a year 13 student, and this year I'm just trying to document things that I think sixth form students need to know, or people moving into sixth form need to know. So if that's the type of stuff you're into, subscribe and join me on my journey. But in today's video I'm going to talk about the Russell Group and if it's important or not, and a bit about the history, just like all the things that I think are relevant and sixth form students need to know before applying, or if they just want to know. But first, a little update about my UCAS right now. This week I got two offers, one of which from the University of Exeter, a Russell Group University, and another one from Portsmouth. So the reason for me making this YouTube video is that I received an offer from a Russell Group University, and like I had looked at it, looked at what Russell Group meant before, but like not into depth. So after getting the offer, I looked more in, I looked deeply into it, and I've just realized some things, and like there are some misconceptions about Russell Group universities. So I'm just going to talk about the history. No more further ado, let's go. Okay, let's go. I spent a couple of days looking into the Russell Group, so I do know a thing or two. So the Russell Group, like what I think you're assuming right now, what I was assuming a couple of days ago, is that the Russell Group were the top 24 universities in the country. Like, just the best 24, that's it. And the name Russell must have meant something intellectual or something, but it's quite much simpler than that. So in 1994, I do believe, well, if I can remember properly, like the Russell Group was founded in a hotel, Hotel Russell, which had these 24 universities inside having a discussion, and they named themselves the Russell Group. Like they just named themselves, they weren't chosen or selected. Like they're basically just, it's just a club and they're all friends. But however, at the time, and like initially, those were the top 24 universities in the country. Like if you look at the map of the original of the Russell Group, they're spread around the UK, and like the Russell Group, they were just the best at the time, 1994. And like, to be fair, right now they are the top universities. I say vaguely they are, like all of which are in the top 50. And so these 24 decided to keep, to make sure they're the top 24, they're just going to research into subject areas and like share the knowledge that they've acquired with each other. So I reckon that if you're doing if you're thinking about doing a postgraduate course, a Russell Group University would be better, because they are constantly researching and they do share stuff with each other. So like if you're doing a postgraduate course, that would be, that'd be better. But for undergraduate, I did struggle to see why Russell Group universities were so good. But after looking into them, like all of them have like a higher teacher to pupil ratio, and like obviously they are great universities, they always score highly, and like their employability from going to these universities is really good. However, like that is accustomed to all the top 50 or so universities in the UK. So if I'm going to be honest with you, like this is just me being straight up, the Russell Group, in the sense of undergraduate courses, isn't really that big or important. However, if you have two universities who are practically the same in each way in ranking, and like you would like to go to either one of them, I would think, or I would choose personally to go to a Russell Group University, because they are going to be teaching like the latest stuff. So say if you're going to study medicine or any other complex or a continually changing course, or a new course, like a Russell Group University would be a preference. And that's why my preference right now is to go to the University of Exeter, which is a Russell Group university, because you want to be knowing like the newest stuff. And especially, I've just said it right now, but medicine, things change all the time. Like, I have parents in the medical field, they're constantly learning stuff. And like, if you're in a university that is dynamic in that sense, always innovating and like teaching their students the best, the newest stuff, I think you'll be at an advantage to other people who don't go to Russell Group universities. Just thinking, and that might be everything. But before I conclude, if you're wondering why isn't my university or Russell Group university, or how come these aren't Russell Group universities, and they are very good and they were like around during 1994, yeah, like it's possibly because they were a polytechnic, which is a type of like college which is past sixth form, but it wasn't like a university yet. But like, I don't remember which year, well, I should know, but I can't remember which year, but like polytechnics just weren't, like the government discontinued them. Like, they told them that they had to turn into universities, and like in that sense, like they weren't as good then. Like, I know in my native city, Sheffield, there's two, Uni of Sheffield and University of Sheffield Hallam, and like Sheffield Hallam was a polytechnic, and Nottingham Trent was a polytechnic. And basically, if you're in a city and there's two universities, the Uni of is the original university, and the other one was a polytechnic. So I think that's it. Okay, that's it. I hope you've enjoyed this YouTube video. It did take me a while to make, as in like research time. So I would appreciate a like and a subscribe. And if you are interested in year 13 and sixth form type of content, subscribe and join the family. So see you next time. Thanks.